Hello viewers, welcome to the ETCIO.com. I am Nikhar Agarwal and I'm in a discussion with Ms. Miao Song. Ms. Song is based out of Belgium and is the global CIO and group vice president of Mars Group. With more than $35 billion in sales, the group produces some of the world's best brands such as M&M, Snickers, Twix, Mars, Dove, Pedigree and more. Along with these consumer brands, they take care of half the world's pet through nutrition, health, and services businesses such as Benefield Pet Hospitals, Pet Partners, and more. With over 20 years of international experience, Ms. Song is managing the IT operations and digital transformation of the group. In the discussion with Ms. Song, we'll try to understand the global insights and how European companies are doing in this crisis. Welcome, ma'am, to ETCIO, and it is our pleasure to have you with us. As you know, while the global economy has been rattled because of the impact of COVID-19, it is up to technology leaders like you to bring back the situation of the business as usual. These are the times when the CIOs have to lead from the front and truly sign technology with business to come up with tangible results and a better ROI. So speaking about the cause, to begin the discussion, I would like to understand what is the impact on your business and how businesses are doing in Europe?
So in the COVID-19 situation, I think a few things we have done very quickly, which I thought very good across the company. One is the response in the IT organization was very quick. So very quickly, we enabled everybody to be able to work from home. So the technology and infrastructure was provided very quickly. And because we drive cloud strategy, so a lot of tools and systems are on cloud that help us to switch to working very quickly. And the company has been addressing the infrastructure challenges in the past few years. So a lot of global network expansion work, network transformation work has been done in the past. That enabled everybody to be able to work from home. So give an example, China obviously went through this, a few months ago. And actually when Europe started lockdown, we quickly enabled other Europe users to work from home. And that one, I think, reasonably well. It was, the first day was a little bit challenging because suddenly everybody worked from home, but the second day it went very well, and we introduced new tools on top of our VPN. So because otherwise your VPN burden will be huge. And we are using all the collaboration tools, including Microsoft 365 on cloud, Teams on cloud, Skype, etc. Balance work from home. We rolled out Zscaler on top of VPN to help people to work from home and connect to the enterprise system. So the first month close was done from financial perspective. Every person worked from home and the financial closure was done smoothly. So that's one thing. That's probably, I call it supporting everybody on the business smoothly during the crisis. Yeah. So that's one thing. The second one is we also looking at, as IT organization, we're also looking at digital transformation. So it's important. In fact, COVID-19 really helped to accelerate digital capabilities during this difficult time. So a few things we're doing. We help the organization for the business priorities continuously run our hospitals and run our manufacturing factories. Exactly. We have about 200 factories in Mars, and for our business, pet nutrition business and pet care business, we still run our productions. We offer the system support, help people to be able to run the system remotely. So that's one of the things we're doing. We're also looking at how we help the business to switch online business, leveraging digital capability as soon as possible. Because in a crisis situation, the online business is booming. So people order food, people order products online instead of going to the supermarket. So we with the D2C, we actually accelerate direct consumer business capabilities during the crisis, along with the business, leveraging agile, leveraging, you know, all the, you know, fastest way of helping the business during the crisis. The third thing we're doing is relook at our investment, because given that the situation, you know, many people are locking down, we leverage a lot of offshore vendors. We relook at our investment in digital and technology, focus on a few things, focus on fixed business priority, business continuity, and protect business continuity, and focus on immediate investment, which will generate cash, NSV, net sales, or protect our supply chain in the short term to overcome the crisis. And we deprioritized the investment, which doesn't, you know, protect business continuity and help to generate short-term business benefit and some of the projects. So that will help us to release some cash and release some, you know, kind of protect our company. And also, obviously, our associated safety and wellness has been removed as a high priority as an organization, IT. You know, so those are the probably four things we're doing. And we're also looking at number five, is looking at how can we overcome, once the crisis is over, how can we get restarted as soon as possible? What other capabilities we should leapfrog in the crisis, primarily looking at online business and digital capabilities of the organization to recover soon. So those are five things we're looking at as an IT organization. I would say call it a CIO battle during a crisis.
Exactly. So, ma'am, as you mentioned, the challenges, your cloud infrastructure, and what are the digital initiatives that you are doing? I would like to ask you that what is the impact, and how are you measuring the ROI with all of these projects and technologies which are being leveraged in the company?
Yeah, so we leverage, in your normal situation, we have an ROI, right? So basically, you depending on what technology you're talking about. If you think about enable more than 20,000, at least, right, half of the organization, 60,000, take example. If you enable 60,000 people working from home, and people still run the business, the ROI is very tangible during a crisis. And some of the company, I know some of the company through talking to my peers, some of the company are challenged. People still have to go to office, or they have to fix their infrastructure. And I think this ROI is really on the business continuity side, and, you know, remove and minimize the business disruption during the crisis. So far, we're working very fine. Yeah, that's one. But the other areas, if you are able to, for example, if you look at CPG or consumer industry, at this time, it's important to understand the consumer demand so that in your supply chain, you are able to produce the right product. Well, food business or pet food business, there is a peak because people trying to stock up their inventories at the moment, the consumers, right? So how can you measure and sense the demand from consumers and from your customers, which is critical, and also using the technology, for example, AI-enabled technology to be able to predict the consumer demand. That will help us to improve our production forecast and knowing where we deliver the right product, where we will produce the right product, which is critical for us during the crisis. And we use, obviously, the tangible KPIs, for example, your inventory forecast, your demand forecast, to measure the success of the technology investment.
Ma'am, if I ask you right now in this crisis, being one of the largest manufacturer in the US and globally, how are you remotely monitoring the manufacturing process, and what is the business impact of COVID-19 on your manufacturing wing and import wing?
Basically? Yeah, so similar to other manufacturing, it's all more or less impacted globally, right? Okay. Everything is impacted. What we're doing is that, so the manufacturing is ongoing. So people still have to present in the factory itself to produce. Right. But the strategy has been shifted that focus on the people's wellness, but take the actions of hygiene and wellness. Yeah, that's one. The second one is developing a dashboard, or, you know, using technology and data, develop dashboard showing the manufacturing performance globally, giving the overview of which factory are still running, which factory, you know, the inventory situation of the factory, the raw material situation of each individual factory. That helps for the management decision based on in a crisis situation.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So, okay, can you please elaborate on some challenges being a being in the Europe and as a global CIO? How do you see, how do you confront these challenges while managing business continuity or while strategizing the BCP plan for Mars Group? So what challenges do you see and how do you, how are you confronting them?
See, I think the challenges is that the every geography, every country are at is at a different stage of the crisis. You know, if you think about the, when the countries are locking down, probably Asia started first, right? China started first, and the rest of Asia, and then and Europe will become epicenter, and then US now. So the challenge is a different stage, inconsistency. I mean, different stage and pace of the crisis. So I have to manage different time zone and different situation. For example, if you think about China, China almost got over the challenge. Now they're talking about new model of transformation through digital, through technology. But then if you go to Europe, you know, people are struggling of, you know, continuously how you keep the business continuity. Then look at the US. The US is the epicenter of the whole world now. And now we're looking at, you know, how can you protect the business priority, but also minimize impact of safety and wellness of people. So I think the biggest challenge is really different stage and different status of different geographies. And you have to really lay out strategy slightly differently in terms of how you invest in technology, how you enable the capabilities, where you enable, where you know you enable the capability, where you should deprioritize your investment in technology at the moment. You can't just give the standard answer to every single country. I mean, take India as an example, right? Few days ago, I think India was locked down. Right. We have a lot of technology vendors in India. Initially, we think we could go ahead with a lot of initiatives. But if you think about what happened starting from last week with the lockdown of the country, a lot of initiatives are actually impacted because even people from home, there's an infrastructure challenge. There is a practicality challenge, you know, and so we have to deprioritize some of the work, you know, given the practicality of whether the work can be done or not. So all the detailed analysis was done through my team during this time, creating time to analyze each individual initiative and project to decide what we should accelerate for each region, what we should stop, what we should pause or delay. We done a very detailed analysis based on the situation of different geographies and different market.
Okay. Ma'am, as you mentioned that you're considering the practicality and due to geographical challenges, accessing vendors and operating those projects and initiatives which are in the pilot stage or you are thinking about for the future per se. So can you highlight few of the projects and initiatives which are being leveraged and which are being implemented in Mars for this particular COVID-19 crisis?
Yeah, so I think if you think about some of the work we're doing, obviously, you know, Asia Pacific. So if you look at in Asia Pacific, we accelerated online business in China specifically, digital capability online business. In the US, we're doing a demand because in the US is our largest market. We're doing a sensing project and doing collaborative planning with our customers. You know, if customers rush to Walmart and the supermarket to buy products, we need to get ready for that in our production and in our delivery. So we together with the customers, we actually collaboratively doing our demand planning through technology solution. That's specific project we are launching in the US. And those are two examples for Europe. We also accelerate some of digital online capabilities at the moment, given that people are not able to go out and everybody's locking down. Some of the project we deprioritize. If you think about at this time, you want to do some fancy stuff, which doesn't make sense during the crisis. We actually took hard decision. We just stop them, right. Pause them at the moment. Yeah.
Exactly. So coming to the IT infrastructure part, as initially you highlighted the cloud infrastructure and applications which are backed by cloud and AI interface, can you quantify and highlight those projects and how the IT support and how cloud-backed infrastructure is actually helping businesses in this critical situation?
Yeah, so the straightforward answer is really easy. If you subscribe mm-hmm. Office 5, you subscribe Teams, you subscribe OneDrive, okay. You just use it prices because the large vendors, for example, right. Teams capability increased 700% during the crisis, right? Okay. You have now you subscribe SaaS solution, you are okay. Almost worried free during the challenge. That's one thing. Okay. Second thing is your infrastructure hosting. Enable right. You to have a solid situation to host your solutions, your ERP, your manufacturing solutions solidly because they are on cloud. You don't have to worry going to your physical location to maintain your server anymore. And that okay. Really gives big benefit to the organization. I know some of the companies are not completely on cloud. They still have some struggle on their local infrastructure. But for us, I think a lot of things, because we leverage cloud as much we can, we are okay. Less burden, so that we can focus on the building the critical digital capabilities okay. During this time. And for all the new digital capabilities, and we want to build on either Microsoft Azure or other cloud solutions, so that when you roll out to the new countries or new right. Geographies, new market, you don't have to worry about this at all. This is okay. Big game with a lot of companies, okay. Yeah. For us
exactly.
As well.
Correct. So are you on 100% cloud or still migrating to cloud?
We are looking at a multi-cloud strategy. We're not 100% okay. Cloud yet. I know some okay. Of the companies probably almost 100%. For us, right. we have some work to do, but I think we are pretty made good progress in this area. Yeah, especially during the crisis. Right.
Correct. So as we discussed about the IT infrastructure, will the IT infrastructure planning and budget allocation change forever post the COVID-19 situation? What are your views on it?
You think, so your question is whether it will be increased or you, yeah.
Right, exactly.
I think post COVID-19, mm-hmm. Companies will accelerate moving to clouds for sure, because okay. That enable you during the crisis, you see the difference during the crisis. Right. I think a lot of companies will start to invest it on cloud and moving okay. To cloud as soon as possible. Okay. Just simply, that's one, because a lot of, I think also secondly, the way of working will be changed.
Right.
I think before crisis, people didn't imagine they can work from home and remotely, exactly. But I believe a lot of people will continuously working from home, virtual working to even connect with the customers, with consumers. That's possible, right? Basically, okay. This means all of the new possibility will come after the right. Crisis.
Right.
Capabilities will be accelerated. Online business, okay. New way of engaging with the consumer and customers will be accelerated, after the crisis.
Exactly. Correct. So as we talked about the raise of budget and how IT planning will peg down in coming future, so how do you think and how are you supporting the business revenue? Do you think IT is supporting to increase and to open new revenue streams for businesses? What's your perspective on it?
See, this is my personal view. It doesn't stand for any company view. It's just a claim.
Okay.
I think right. So. I think every company is a technology company. Whether they admit it or not, is a technology company. So the technology actually is the core of the business. The technology is not technology, is your business. So okay. Specifically after crisis, I think the way consumer buy product, the way the company run the right. Manufacturing operation will be much more digital and technology okay. Driven. Being able to forecast the demand, driving automation, right. Driving chain, digital value chain or supply chain will be the key,
right.
And also being able to respond mm-hmm. from different geographies as quickly as possible will okay. Be the key to win the business in the future.
Okay. So, ma'am, talking about as we have discussed about new revenue streams and how businesses are going to grow with IT support. So, what will be the future impact when we will all resume our offices? When the businesses will resume? What will be the situation in the coming future, from your perspective?
See, I think the coming. So, obviously, again, my personal view doesn't stand for any company.
Okay,
After the crisis, some of the business will not be able to survive. You already see the company, right. Some of the company are, some of startups will not be able to survive. Some of the business of, if you do a travel booking, airline, really tough, right? They are not, some of the smaller business will die. But on the other hand, I would say there will be some emerging business as well. The business who are native, digital native, who doesn't need heavy infrastructure, who doesn't need heavy manpower to run the business, will survive and thrive as well. So anybody who actually really come out during the crisis, running business online, being able to create some new revenue, new value proposition, will thrive. Yeah, some of the taking care of some of the unmet needs during the crisis. Yeah, I actually think online business grew so big during the crisis. Yeah.
Okay. Coming back to the work from home phase, as in your company, a majority number of employees are working from home, and globally we talk about the number. So a majority number of employees are working from home. They are accessing data. They are accessing cloud applications. How do you manage security in such crisis? What is your strategy for IT security, which is for remote monitoring or some VPN encryption? What is your mantra for it?
Yeah, so we rolled out some new tools recently on top of VPN. For example, we rolled out Zscaler as a new tool to monitor the network, monitor the remote access. That's one. The second one, our CISO can also talk about this. Our cyber team actually looking at strictly monitoring the situation. In fact, there are more phishing emails during the crisis. You will see a lot of fake news, phishing emails during the crisis.
Exactly. Hackers.
So we actually strengthened our cyber actions during the crisis. There was regular review, regular continuously monitoring to make sure we run this safely during the crisis. It's actually much more strong than ever. And I think every company should do that at this time, because you can't imagine the hacker hacking to your operation. Right? They give a lot of opportunity at the moment for hackers. More active during this time.
All right, ma'am. Coming to your leadership and your expertise, as you attend so many global conferences and you meet so many global IT leaders, CIOs, what is the market trend right now in Europe about and for which technologies which are being heavily leveraged? Where are the investments going from a global CIO perspective?
I see. This is my view. Again, this is not company
Definitely.
View. This is based
your
on my personal. Yeah, I think I think the technology cloud is absolutely, if the company hasn't done cloud, absolutely a lot of investment will be on cloud technology. I think machine learning, AI, will be a big time. I think in the future, quantum computing and 5G will be a big time as well. If you think about during the crisis, everybody need fastest pace, speed of the network. I think 5G will make a difference. Quantum computing for sure for the future. Those are the three things in my list. Obviously, there are other technologies, but I think this might not be compared with those three. I think these three will make huge difference. Yeah.
Correct. Are you leveraging machine learning and cloud AI driven software? I mean,
yes,
are you doing some AI modeling?
Mm-hmm. Yes, we do. Yeah.
Okay, from manufacturing perspective and for the operations perspective, I mean, for
manufacturing operation in different businesses, yes, yeah.
Okay, can you highlight something about where you have automated using machine learning and AI? Any recent project or something?
Yeah, so many projects, for example, if you have data processing, repetitive data processing processes, and we leverage bots and leveraging machine learning AI technology to automate the process to get some benefit. We also have some AI technologies in our veterinary hospitals to help to make some better decisions, AI-based decision through machine learning to help the doctor to make the right and better decision. And so the AI-enabled bots to connect with the consumers in some of our online websites. We're not 100% there yet, but we got started to connect with the consumer through AI technology. Right. So these are some examples we're doing.
Okay, that's really great, ma'am. So coming to our last question, as India is yet to see the full impact of COVID-19 and the coronavirus spread, well, we hope we didn't see it like the Europe is witnessing right now. What message would you like to give to the Indian CIOs for better understanding and preparation for this courage? What do you like to share from your experience and expertise, which can be added into the hygiene of Indian CIOs?
Yeah, so I actually see, I was in India mid of January, I think, the end of January. I really love my trip. I was in Hyderabad, I was in, I was in different locations. I still remember vividly at that time, there was only one case, two cases in India at the time, January. But you will see that now we are 3 months later and the situation really is it's very tough. I think my first based on my experience coming out of this crisis, I mean, not out yet, in the middle of the crisis, I think the first one is respond quickly. Don't assume it won't change, the situation won't change. I think fast is you can respond, get ready better. So get ready for your infrastructure, your technology to support a crisis, and business continuity is number one. You have to really think about it now rather than just, hey, you know, maybe we'll get over it. But, you know, this has to be a prerequisite. And the second one, I think it's really focus your investment on the key stuff, not focus doing everything. In a normal situation, you can do a lot of stuff, but now you have to focus two or three things where you really can make a difference, can really help your business in during a crisis. I think the third one is continuously lead your organization, take care of your people, because people is the most important assets. Without people, you can't do anything. So what I do with my team now is actually I do regular check-in with every individual in my team to make sure they're doing okay and checking how they're doing, because to being isolated in the, at home is not a good thing. You have to take care of your people on emotion piece, care for the well-being of people. So I would say that in the crisis, those are the three things, you know, you have to get ready as a technology leader.
Correct. Exactly. Well, that's great, ma'am. Thank you very much for your expertise and insights, global insights. Anything else you would like to add in this interview, in our video interview?
I think just the key message, I mean, that the crisis, not ever, right? So it's not forever, but I think the spirit rising from the crisis is the difference we can make, right? So keep our spirit and being optimistic is more important than anything else.
Correct. That's right, ma'am. That's right. The words full of wisdom. Thank you very much, ma'am, for your great words and your global insights and sharing your experience with us.